वेक्टर सब स्पेस. फर्स्ट लेट अस सी इट्स डेफिनेशन. सपोज लेट वी बी ए वेक्टर स्पेस ओवर द फील्ड एफ एंड डब्ल्यू बी ए सबसेट ऑफ वी. देन द सबसेट डब्ल्यू इज कॉल्ड ए सब स्पेस ऑफ वी इफ डब्ल्यू इटसेल्फ इज ए वेक्टर स्पेस ओवर एफ विद रिस्पेक्ट टू द ऑपरेशंस ऑफ वेक्टर एडिशन एंड स्केलर मल्टीप्लीकेशन इन वी. इट मीन्स डब्ल्यू इज क्लोज्ड with respect to vector addition and scalar multiplication. These two operations are operations of V and W is a subset of V. Only then we will say that W is subspace when W is a vector space for these two operations. See theorem 1. The necessary and sufficient condition for a non-empty subset W of a vector space VF to be a subspace of V is that W is closed under vector addition and scalar multiplication in V. This is what the definition says. See its proof. If W, we need to prove necessary and sufficient condition. So if W is a vector space over F with respect to vector addition and scalar multiplication in V, then W must be closed with respect to these two compositions. So first part is proved. Second, the condition is sufficient. Now suppose that W is a non-empty subset of V and W is closed under vector addition and scalar multiplication in V. Then what we need to do? We need to do that W is a vector space or W is a subspace of V. See, let alpha be in W. If 1 is the unity element of F, then minus 1 will be in F since F is a field. Now W is closed under scalar multiplication. Therefore, minus 1 belongs to F, alpha belongs to W. It implies that minus 1 into alpha belongs to W. It means minus 1 alpha belongs to W or minus alpha is in W. Thus, the additive inverse of each element of W is also in W. So W contains all additive inverses of its elements. Now W is closed under vector addition. See this. Therefore, alpha belongs to W, minus alpha belongs to W. It implies that alpha plus minus alpha belongs to W. It implies that zero vector belongs to W, where this zero vector is the zero vector of V. Hence, the zero vector of V is also the zero vector of W. Now, since the elements of W are also the elements of V, therefore, vector addition will be commutative as well as associative in W, as we have studied the definitions of commutative and associative additions. Hence, this W is an abelian group with respect to vector addition. Also, it is given that W is closed under scalar multiplication. Earlier, we have assumed in sufficient condition that W is closed under scalar multiplication. The remaining postulates of a vector space will hold in W since they hold in V. Of which W is a subset. Therefore, W is a vector space for the two composition. This completes our sufficient part. Therefore, W is a subspace of V. See another theorem. The necessary and sufficient conditions for a non-empty subset W of a vector space VF to be a subspace of V are alpha belongs to W, beta belongs to W. It implies that alpha minus beta is in W. And A belongs to F, alpha belongs to W. It implies that A alpha belongs to W. See its proof. Proof. The conditions are necessary. If W is a subspace of V, then W is an abelian group with respect to vector addition. It is the first, very first condition for a subset to be a vector space. Therefore, alpha belongs to W and beta belongs to W. It implies that alpha minus beta will be in W. Also, W must be closed under scalar multiplication. Therefore, condition 2 is also necessary. Second part, the conditions are sufficient. Now, suppose that W is a non-empty subset satisfying the two conditions, the two given conditions. Then first, we have alpha belongs to W and alpha belongs to W. It implies that alpha minus beta, alpha minus alpha belongs to W. Implies a zero vector belongs to W. This is from the first condition. So the zero vector of V belongs to W and it will be the zero vector of W. Now, 0 vector belongs to W, alpha belongs to W, it implies 0 minus alpha belongs to W, it means minus alpha belongs to W. So, W contains additive inverse of alpha also. Again, alpha belongs to W, beta belongs to W, implies alpha belongs to W and minus beta belongs to W. From here, if alpha is in W, then minus alpha is in W. So, for beta, minus beta is also in W. It implies that alpha minus beta belongs to W from condition 1. So, alpha plus beta belongs to W. It means W is closed with respect to vector addition. Next, since the elements of W are also the elements of V, therefore, vector addition will be commutative as well as associative in W. Hence, this W is an abelian group under vector addition. Also, from condition 2, W is closed under scalar multiplication. The remaining postulates will hold in W since they are satisfied in V. Of which W is a subset and W is a subspace of V. This proves our sufficient part. Now you have theorem 3, the necessary and sufficient condition for a non-empty subset W of a vector space VF to be a subspace of V is that AB belongs to F and alpha beta belongs to W implies that A alpha plus B beta belongs to W. It is very important theorem because it will be used for some problems also, which you can prove using this condition that AB belongs to F and alpha beta belongs to W implies alpha plus beta belongs to W. If any subset satisfies this condition, then that will be treated as a vector subspace. Okay. Now the condition is necessary. If W is a subspace of V, then W must be closed under scalar multiplication and vector addition, the very first conditions. Therefore, A belongs to F, alpha belongs to W, it implies A alpha will be in W. And B belongs to F, beta belongs to W, implies B beta will be in W. Now, A alpha belongs to W and B beta belongs to W. From this, it implies that A alpha plus B beta will be in W, since W is closed with under vector addition, hence the condition is necessary. First part is proved. Now come to second part, the condition is sufficient. Now suppose W is a non-empty subset of V, satisfying the given condition that AB belongs to F and alpha beta belongs to W implies A alpha plus B beta belongs to W. Now what we need to prove that? We need to prove that this W is a subspace of V. See, take A is equal to 1 and B is equal to 1. Then from this you get alpha plus beta belongs to W. See? Therefore, W is closed under addition, vector addition. Therefore, W is closed. Now take A is equal to minus 1, B is equal to 0. So from A alpha plus beta belongs to W, you get minus 1 alpha plus 0 into alpha belongs to W. So it implies that minus alpha belongs to W. It means W contains additive inverse of each element of W. Take A is equal to 0 and B is equal to 0. Then 0 alpha plus 0 alpha belongs to W, it means 0 plus 0, it means 0 vector belongs to W. So the 0 vector, this 0 vector belongs to V and it belongs to W also. Now since the elements of W, they are also the elements of V, therefore vector addition will be associative as well as commutative in V. Therefore W is an abelian group with respect to vector addition. Now take beta is equal to 0, then AB belongs to F and alpha belongs to W. Then A alpha plus B0 belongs to W, that is A alpha belongs to W. It means W is closed under scalar multiplication. Now the remaining postulates of a vector space will also hold in W since they are holding in V. Hence WF is a subspace of VF. This is our, this proves our second part. Now come to some examples. Example one. Let VF be any vector space. Suppose V over F is a vector space, then V itself and the subset of V consisting of zero vector only are always subspaces of V. These are two trivial subspaces, or here they are called improper subspaces, means subspace V and the subspace containing the zero vector only. If V has any other subspace, then we call it a proper subspace. The subspace of V consists of zero vector only. It's called the zero subspace. See another example which has used the earlier theorem. The set W of order triads A1, A2, 0, where A1, A2 belongs to F, is a subspace of V3F. See its solution. Suppose we have two vectors alpha and beta. Alpha is denoted as A1 into 0 and beta is B1 into 0. They are any two elements of W. Then obviously A1 into and B1 into belongs to F from the given problem. Suppose A and B be any two elements of F, then A alpha plus B beta will be A1 into 0 plus B1 into 0. It means A1 A2 0 plus B1 B2 0. It means A1 plus B1 A2 plus B2 0. This belongs to W since A1 plus BB1 and A2 plus BB2, they will belong to F because F is a field. Thus, W is a subspace of V because of the earlier theorem 3, which says that for A, B in F and alpha, beta in V, alpha plus beta belongs to W, then W will be a vector subspace. So, see one more example you can see here. Let V be the vector space of all polynomials in an indeterminate X over a field F. V is a vector space containing all polynomials. And W is a subspace of subset of V consisting of all polynomials of degree less than or equal to N. Then W is a subspace of V. Take alpha and beta, any two elements of W, then alpha will be a polynomial of degree less than or equal to N. Beta is also a polynomial of degree less than or equal to N as per the given problem. Suppose A and B are any two elements of F, then A alpha plus B beta, it will also be a polynomial of degree less than or equal to N since A and B, they are constants. And alpha and beta, they are polynomials of degree less than or equal to N. So their sum will also be a polynomial of degree less than or equal to N. It means A alpha plus B beta belongs to W. Hence, W is a subspace of V. So it is all about today's class. If you have any query, raise your hands, ask your questions.